Good afternoon, everyone. How are you today? Good afternoon, dear students. Welcome to your second face-to-face class. My name is Eliana Cifuentes, and I am tutor of Pearson Academy. This PowerPoint, this presentation, or this face-to-face class is for students of the third level modalidad presencial. Welcome again to this class. Well, I'd like to know how many students do I have? Third level. I know I have some students in Tulcán. Please, could you tell me how many students do we have in Tulcán? How many students are in Tulcán? What about Ibarra?
My name is Carmita Panama.
Hello? Yeah? Please, could you tell me your names, please?
Carmita Panama. Ibarra.
Carmita. Carmita, you are in Ibarra. Carmita, are there more students in your class?
What?
Are there more students in your class?
No.
Only you? Okay, Carmita, thank you. Welcome to this class. I can see some students in Tulcán. Please, could you introduce yourselves?
Hello, teacher. My name is Carmen Chamba.
Carmen. Carmen, you are in Tulcán.
Yes.
Carmen, are there more students in your class? No more students, only you?
No.
Okay, Carmen, thank you. In other provinces, please, in other centers.
Hello. My name is Maribel Or.
Maribel?
Or.
Yeah, Maribel. Where are you? Where are you from?
From Coca.
El Coca?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, Maribel, thank you. No more students in your class?
No.
Only you?
Only.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, what about Esmeraldas? Students in Esmeraldas? Students in Guaranda, La Tacunga, Macas, Machala?
Hello.
Hello.
Centro Nueva Loja, Silvana Fonseca.
Silvana? Nueva Loja.
Nueva Loja.
Okay, Silvana, are there more students?
No.
No, okay, thank you. What about El Puyo, Puerto Viejo, Riobamba, Santo Domingo, Quevedo, Tena, Tulcán, Zamora, Ambato, Ibarra, San Rafael? No? No more students. Okay. Okay, anyway, thank you. Thank you for coming to this face-to-face class. Well, this is an active class, so your participation as always is very, very important. Please, I'd like to all of you take your microphones and participate, please. This is just to say that according to the academic calendar, today is December 14. According to the calendar, we have the second face-to-face class in all the centers of UTPL. Another important date, it is on December 19th. If you want to change the center or to take the final test, remember you have to ask from December 19th to January 7th. And the final exam will be on January the 19th. No, the 17th. From 17th to 19th will be the final exam, the final test. So this test will be published, will be announced on February the 3rd. So it is important to check the academic calendar. Anyway, UTPL will be sending some emails to your personal and the UTPL emails, sending this important information. Well, again, the methodology. I advise to work on the platform. Please remember, you will get 10 extra points if you work on the platform. But to get these extra points, these are extra points, in your final test, you need at least 20 over 40. 20 over 40 points to receive your extra points. To pass the level, the final test, it is over 40. Remember, the final test and the extra points, they are added to help the final score. To pass the level, you need 28 points. If you work on the platform, you will have three opportunities to pass your level. You have a final test. If unfortunately you don't pass the test, you will have two makeup tests, dos exámenes supletorios, si es que no pasen su examen final. But if you work on the platform, if you don't work on the platform, you only have one opportunity, the final test, and that's it. All the activities you complete on the platform, they are scored like this. The 10 extra points are divided in this way. 2 points for all the activities of reading, 2 points for writing, 2 for listening, and 4 points for speaking tasks. So please try to do all your speaking tasks. Okay, this is just to remind you. The contents. According to your platform, you are in this. This is your platform. Okay, you are using Top Notch number 1, and according to the platform, you have from Unit 6 to Unit 10. This is a review from Unit 6 to Unit 10. Okay, according to this, the most important topics are grammar, the use of can and can't, have to, to express obligation, and some other parts, okay? So the most important topics I have taken for this, let me see, review. All right, as this is an active class, please take your microphones and try to participate in class. If you have a question, please. Now, which are the contents? Here we have a review of can and can't. This is a modal verb, can and can't, to show possibility. The use of have to express obligation. simple present and present continuous. The differences between simple present and present continuous: the past tense of be, the simple past tense, object pronouns, comparatives, future with going to, should and could, superlatives, and the use of to and enough. These are the can tense from units 6 to 10. All right? Now, do you remember can? What is can? Can, as a modal verb, it is used to express possibility. It also is used to express ability. When you say, for example, I can draw, I can draw well, this is an ability. But can, it is also used to express possibility. Something it is possible to happen in the future, okay? So, can in affirmative sentences to express possibility have this structure. I can play on Sunday. Possibility. If I have time, I can play on Saturday. If I have time, I can meet you at 10. This is possibility. You can, he can, she can, we can, they can. So can, it is used for all the personal pronouns. We don't need to change one for all of these personal pronouns. So we use can with all of them. And one important thing, after a modal verb, we use the base form of the verb. It means we don't say to play, no infinitives. To meet, no infinitive. So we use only play, meet, teach, drive, etc. Okay, now tell me some things you can do as a possibility. Here we have some words: airport, late, party, visit. Use these words to express an action, an activity that can be a possibility. For example, I can take my son to the airport. I can take my son to the airport. What about you? Carmita, what can you do? Tell me something, a possibility, something that you can do using can. Carmita, Carmen, Maribel, Silvana. Okay, all of us, we have to participate. So give me some examples. Or you can use my mother can, my father can, my family can, but to express possibility, a future possibility. I can, what? No? You can use party. You can use visit. Any word. So no problem. Well, to form a sentence, we only need a subject. Here I have the subject. The modal can and the verb. Remember some verbs: study, work, go, come, teach, practice, exercise, speak, sing, write, any verb. So you only need to choose a subject, can, and the base form of the verb. You add the complement, and that's it. We have an affirmative sentence. To say something that is possible. Another example, for example, using him. My husband can meet me at 6 p.m. Yeah, possibility. It is possible. My husband can meet me, can wait for me at 6 p.m. What about you? Give me any example. Vamos, deme ejemplos. Cualquier oración que exprese posibilidad. To show possibility. Yep. No, no idea. You don't want to participate? I can't wait for you. I can't wait for you. So, give me some examples. Vamos, chicos. Chicas. Todos, tomen su micrófono y participemos en clase. Deme una oración que exprese posibilidad.
Buenas tardes. Le saluda Mari de Macas.
Mari. Thank you, Mari.
Voy a hacer un ejemplo. Me corrige si está bien o mal.
Okay.
I can dance in the morning the party.
I can dance at the party.
In the morning.
I can dance in the morning. Yeah, this could be possibility. All right. In the morning, it is possible to dance in the morning. Okay. I can dance in the morning at the party. Well, good. Yeah, another example. You can use he or she. Instead of he, you can say my father, my brother. Instead of she, you can say my best friend. Any subject. Vamos, cualquier sujeto. Yeah.
Hello,
all right,
teacher.
Permita.
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
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 Hello, teacher.
What's your name?
My name is Edward. I'm from Orellana.
Edward.
Yes.
Okay, Edward.
I can drive on Saturday.
I can write what? Write a letter.
Drive.
Okay. If you want to express possibility, yeah, it could be possible. I can drive on Saturday. Good. I can drive on Saturday. Excellent. Yeah, more examples. Try to use he. Instead of he, we can say my brother, my friend, my boyfriend, my dad, my cousin. Yeah, use he. He can, or my father can, what? All of you have to give me an example. Todos me van a dar un ejemplo. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 students. So, tell me your examples. Think of an example. To express possibility. Yeah? Are you ready? Come on. Carmita, Carmen, Maribel. Okay, with Maribel. Maribel, what can you say?
Fishing?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. He can visit in Coca City.
He can visit, but we don't say in Coca City. We can visit who? We can visit my friends, our friends. We can visit our friends on Sunday. This is possible. We can visit our friends on Sunday in El Coca. Okay, good. Yeah, another one. Mary from Macas. Vamos, chicos, cualquier verbo. To express possibility.
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
My name is Carolina.
Carolina, thank you. Welcome.
From Guaranda.
Carolina from Guaranda. Excellent, Carolina. Okay, give me an example, Carolina. We are talking about it. Yeah, Ken.
My brother can play soccer.
My brother can play soccer. To express possibility, if you want to express possibility, you have to add a time. You have to add an expression, a time expression. That means possibility. Because if you only say, my brother can play soccer, this is ability. Remember, can is used to express ability. I can play, I can draw, ability. I can speak three languages, ability. But in this case, we use can to express possibility, that something, it is possible to happen, right? So my brother can play soccer next Sunday, right? It's good. Good. What else? Maribel or Silvana? Let's say my parents. Yeah.
Hey. Mm-hmm. Mari nuevamente.
Mari, thank you, Mari.
My brother can drive the bus on Monday.
On Monday. Good. My brother can drive the bus on Monday. Yes, this is possible to happen. Excellent. So this is an affirmative sentence using can to express possibility. Very good. What about the negative? We use can't to express negative possibility. So, in this case, we have three forms to express negative. Cannot, can't, and this way, cannot as one word. Yeah? Again, the structure is the same. Can't for negative possibility. So, we can say, I can't. The pronunciation is clearly can't. You have to pronounce letter T. I can't play on Saturday. She can't meet at noon. So you see, it is important to mention a time expression. Una expresión de tiempo. The time expression gives me the possibility to happen something. Yeah, right. Tell me more examples, but in this case, negative sentences. I cannot play on Saturday. I cannot play on Saturday because I am in class. I cannot go to the disco on Saturday because I'm in class. Right. You cannot meet at noon. We cannot meet us at noon, right? Yeah, give me another example. Any example. A ver, Carmita, Carmen, Maribel, Silvana, Mary, Edward, Carolina. This is your turn.
Hello, teacher. My dear friend, can dance on weekend.
My girlfriend can
dance any weekend.
Weekend? What is weekend?
Weekend, fin de semana.
Weekend. Hey, pero ¿y dónde está el verbo? ¿Cuál es el verbo? My dance. Girlfriend can't dance.
Yes.
Ah, yeah. My girlfriend can't dance on the weekend. Good. Why? Because she's in class. All right. Very good. Yeah, one more. Try to speak. You know, it is important for me to listen to you because I can hear your pronunciation. Hey, chicos, es importante que ustedes participen en clase porque yo puedo escuchar su pronunciación y puedo corregir la pronunciación. So, don't worry about that, but participate in class. Participen en clase, vamos. Cualquier idea es bienvenida. Yeah. We cannot go early.
Teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Mary.
Mary.
She cannot run in the morning.
She cannot run in the morning. Okay. She cannot run in the morning. Good. Negative possibility. What else?
Teacher.
Uh-huh.
My friend cannot play on Sunday.
Sunday. Repeat, Sunday.
Sunday.
My friend can't... Can what? Can
play. Read? Play.
Ah, can play.
Play.
On Sunday. My friend can't play on Sunday. Wow. Good. One more.
Hi, teacher.
Hi.
My son can play on tomorrow.
We don't say on tomorrow. We only say tomorrow. Oh. My son can't play tomorrow. Okay. This is negative possibility. He can't play tomorrow. Pronunciation is important. In present, we say can, can. It is a sound we don't have in Spanish. Can. But in negative, we have to pronounce letter T. We say can't or cannot. My friend cannot play on Saturday. They cannot meet at noon. All right, excellent. Now, and questions. For questions, as always, the verb, in this case, the modal verb, goes before the subject. This is a structure. And for a question, we say, can you go to the bank now? Can he go to the bank now? Can he take your card? Can she take your card? Can they go to the bank now? This is a yes, no question. Remember, yes, no questions, they always have the answer yes or no. If I say, hey, can you go to the bank now? You say, yes, I can. Or no, I can't. Oh, sorry, no, I can't. I am in class. You see? Can my brother go to the disco tonight? No, he can't. He has to work. Right. So, one more, one example. Make a question. Make a question to your friend. What can you say? Can you make me a question? Hey, a question.
Can you play the guitar?
Can you play the guitar in the afternoon? No, I can't. I can't play the guitar. Okay. Silvana, can you go to the library in the afternoon? Silvana, this is a question for you. Can you go to the library in the afternoon? Hello, Silvana. Are you still there? Is anybody there?
Hey, teacher.
Yeah.
Can he go to, a ver, ¿cómo sería? To take class now?
Repeat again. Can?
Can he go to the class now?
Can he go?
Row.
No. Row? What is row? Draw?
It's listening.
How do you spell?
In the class, no.
Now, you say now.
Listen.
Can you speak in class now?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Can you speak in class now? Yeah. Yes, I can.
Yes, I can.
Yes, I can. No, I can't. Right. And this, what about the question to Maribel? I said, can you go to the library in the afternoon? Maribel, can you go to the library in the afternoon?
Repeat, please.
Can you go to the library in the afternoon?
I am.
Sorry, repeat again.
No, I am come.
No puedo decir I am. Epa, pay attention to this. Si la pregunta dice, if the question says, can you... Sorry, pay attention to this. The question says, can you go to the library in the afternoon? This is the question. Okay. In the answer, you cannot say, I'm. Can you go to the library in the afternoon? Can, it is the auxiliary. Can is the modal verb, okay? So, remember, can you go to the library in the afternoon? Can is the auxiliary. Can is the most important part. Sorry, here, yeah? And this is, wait. Can you go to the library in the afternoon? Yeah, this is the question. Can you go to the library in the afternoon? This is a yes, no question. We call yes, no question because at the beginning we have the auxiliary. In this case, it is a modal verb. Si en la pregunta tengo el verbo modal can, en la respuesta tengo el verbo modal can. Si en la pregunta tengo el verbo do, por ejemplo, do you speak English? En la respuesta tendré el mismo auxiliar, yes, I do. Si en la pregunta tengo, are you in class, el verbo to be, en la respuesta tendré el verbo to be, yes, I am. So, as this is a yes, no question, la respuesta, the answer, automatically it is yes or no. And I say yes or no. To give the answer, we use yes, the subject, and the auxiliary, in this case, the modal verb, and say, yes, I can. Short answer. Yes, I can. So, in the question, you have the modal verb can. In the answer, you have the same auxiliary. Yes, I can. If you want to say no, you say, no, I can't. Sorry, no tengo el auxiliar can, tengo el apóstrofe. Right here. And I say, no, I can't. No, I can't. Right? So, can you go to the library in the afternoon? Yes, I can. No, I can't. Yeah, very quickly. We are going to practice these answers very quickly. And I say, change the verb. And I say, hey, can you study? Can you study English tonight? Can you study English tonight? What's your answer?
Yes, I can.
Yes, I can.
In negative?
No, I can't.
No, I can't. Okay, change the verb. This is now. Yeah. Change the verb. Can you, no study, can you speak? Can you speak English at the conference room? At the conference, yeah? Can you speak English at the conference?
Yes, I can. Yes.
No, I can't.
No, I can't. Okay. Change the verb. Yeah, no speak. What could be? Can you give me another example? Can you travel? Can you travel at night? Yes, I can. No,
yes, I can't.
Yes, I can. No, I can't. Uh-huh. Yeah. Now, more examples. Instead of travel. Give me more examples. Can you? Cualquier verbo.
Can you dance? I like.
Can you dance? Can you dance at night? Yeah. Yes, I can. No, I can't. Another verb.
Can you eat?
Change the verb. Can you eat? Can you eat out at night? Mm-hmm. Yes, I can. No, I can't. Now, this is a short answer. What about the long answer? You say, hey, can you eat, Carmen? Can you eat out at night? You say, yes, I can. If you want to give a full answer, you can say, I can eat out at night. So you repeat. Yes, I can. I can eat out at night. Good. If you say in negative, you can give an excuse, for example. Mary, can you eat out at night? And you say, oh, no, I can't. I'm sorry. No, I can't. I am very busy at night. Yeah, I am very busy at night. So you see, the important thing it is you speak speak enjoying phrases. Right. One more example. Tell me another example. One more example, please. Can you? Yeah, complete. Complete the phrase.
Can you travel at night?
Can you what? Can you travel? Pero no digo a travel. No puedo decir a travel. Porque a travel significa un viaje. ¿Puedes tú un viaje? No creo. Solo necesito un verbo en su forma simple. Can you travel? Can you travel at night? Yes, I can. No, I can't. If you say yes, I can, you say yes. I can travel at night. Yes, I can. I'm sorry. Yes, I can travel at night. In negative, what can you say in the negative? Edward. Can you travel at night? You say, no, I can't.
No, I can't travel at night.
No, I can't. Sorry, I'm what? I'm late.
I'm late.
Okay. Yeah, it will be. Excellent. So this is the structure of a question. Question, remember, can is used to express ability, but also is used to express possibility. Okay, good. Now let's continue. Now let's remember the use of have to. What is have to? To. This is an expression, have to, it is an expression used to express obligation. Obligation. And have to, it is used in affirmative sentences, negative sentences, questions and answers. So, here I have an example. I have to work. I have to work late. So it means it is an obligation. Something that is an obligation, you use have to. What does it mean? Yo tengo que trabajar. I have to work. Yo tengo que trabajar. Yo tengo que estudiar. Ella tiene que dormir. She has to. Okay, so for I, you, we, and they, we use have to in the affirmative sentence. For he, she, and it, we use has to in the affirmative. You say, I have to study English. Yeah, for me it's an obligation. For you it's an obligation. You say, oh, I have to study English tonight. You have to study English tonight. He has to study English tonight. She has to study English. We have to study English. They have to study English in affirmative sentence. Okay, tell me some examples. Something that you have as an obligation. Yeah, using I. I have to work. Teacher, and you? What about you?
Teacher.
Yeah?
She has to travel?
Mm-hmm. She has to travel to Loja. Excellent. This is an obligation because she lives in Loja, so she has to travel in Loja, to travel to Loja. Excellent. Yeah, another example.
Teacher?
Carolina. Mm-hmm.
He has to run.
He has to run. Pronunciation. Run. This. Run. Uh-huh. Run. She has to run. Yeah, but pay attention. Try to get more information. Try to complete the information. He has to run in the park. He has to run in the competition. She has to run in the, this afternoon. Try to complete the sentence, yeah? Very good. So,
okay.
Now, instead of she, vamos, en lugar de she, we can say my sister, my friend, my mom, my daughter, my cousin. Yeah, tell me something about she.
Teacher.
She?
Mary.
Uh-huh. Mary.
Con she, puedo pasarle a my sister have to eat now.
Ah. Okay, ¿qué dice aquí con she? Con she no has puedo utilizar to. Have, sino has.
Has
to.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My sister, repeat again.
My sister has to eat now.
Uh-huh. My sister has to eat now because she has to take a medicine. Okay, if she has to take a medicine, maybe she needs the full the stomach. All right. You can say she has to eat now because she has to take a medicine. Excellent. My Thanks. Sister has to eat now. Yeah. What else? More. Using we. Give me an example using we.
Teacher.
Mm-hmm.
She does not has. Do live in Tulcán.
A ver, repeat again. She.
Ya me equivoqué, perdón.
Ajá.
My sister do not. I live in Tulcán.
It is incorrect. Aquí tengo la estructura, mija. Mira. La primera es oración afirmativa. I have to work. Affirmative sentence. He has to work. She has to work. We have to work. Affirmative sentences. Primero estamos en oración afirmativa. Entonces, dame un ejemplo con oración afirmativa. Dices, she... ¿Qué? ¿Qué va?
She has to...
Has
I
to?
Live.
Pero no I live. ¿Para qué le pongo el I?
No I.
No I. Solamente necesito un verbo principal acá. Si tú dices I live, estás diciendo yo vivo en Quito. Dices, él tiene que, yo vivo en Quito. Tienes que decir, he has to live. Ella tiene que vivir en Quito, right? He or she has to live in Quito. Vamos, otro ejemplo. She okay. has to... Algo que sea obligatorio.
My father has to get in the army.
Yeah, my father has to...
To get in the army.
To sleep early, yeah. Good. He has to sleep early. Very good. Yeah, one more. Vamos, otro ejemplo. My sister has to... Aquí solo necesito un verbo, cualquier verbo. For example, tomorrow I have an exam. If you have an exam tomorrow, what is your obligation? You say, study. If I have an exam tomorrow, My obligation is to study. And I say, my sister has to study for the test tomorrow. Yeah. My sister has to. Give me one more example. Yeah. Practice your English. Please practice your English. Another example. Something that is an obligation. For you, it is an obligation. You have to speak in English in class. Or you have to speak English in class. Yeah, like this. It is an obligation.
Teacher, another example.
Okay.
He has to swim.
Repeat the verb.
She has.
Read.
No, she has to swim in the pool now.
Yeah, she has to swim in the pool. Very good. Yeah, excellent. She has to swim because, hey, she has a contest could be a competition. She has a competition, so she has to swim, right? You can say, hey, my dad, what is something, an obligation for your dad? My dad...
Has to work in the morning.
Yeah, good. It is good. This is an obligation. My dad has to work in the morning. Now, pay attention to the pronunciation. These two words. The pronunciation of these two words, eh? Normally, we pronounce or we link these two words and we say has to. Very quickly, has to. My sister has to study. You have to speak. Has to swim. Has to work. Quickly, you have to link. When we speak in English, we have to link. You understand what is link? Tratemos de unir las palabras. Has to study, have to speak, has to swim, has to work. Has to. The correct pronunciation is has to. Has to. Has to swim, have to swim. Right? Remember, for he, she, and it, we use has. For the others, we use have. You have. What about this? Maria's Yeah, give me an example. Yeah, Maria's boyfriend. Yeah. Yeah, complete the sentence.
Afternoon.
Maria's boyfriend.
Has to. Okay.
Has to what?
Pizza in the afternoon.
Okay, Maria's boyfriend has to pick her up in the afternoon. Okay. Yeah. So repeat again. Has to. Has to. Have to. Try to link. Has to. Have to. All right. Let's continue. This is an affirmative sentence. Now, when we say in negative, a negative obligation, we use don't have. And we say, I don't have to. Something that it is not an obligation. You say, my sister doesn't have to study for the test tomorrow. Now, pay attention to the negative sentence. In the affirmative, we say have to or has to. For the negative, we use the auxiliary don't and doesn't. Doesn't, it is used for he, she, and it, and don't for the other, for the others. Say, my sister doesn't have to. My sister doesn't have to study for the test tomorrow. What about the next? Tell me the next. What? A negative. Tell me the negative. The second sentence changed into the negative.
You.
Yeah.
What?
You.
You don't have to speak English in class.
You don't have to speak English in class. Very good. What about the next? Him. Him.
He doesn't have to.
No.
No.
In the affirmative sentence, we use has. ¿Verdad que en la oración afirmativa utilizo has to? Pero en la negativa utilizo doesn't have to. No es doesn't has. Dice, him.
He doesn't have to swim the pool now.
He doesn't have to. Exactly. We change this and we say have to. He doesn't have to swim in the pool now. Very good. What about my dad? A negative obligation. My dad
doesn't have to work in the morning.
Me falta el verbo. Doesn't qué?
Have to.
Exactly. Have to. We don't say has, we say have to. My dad doesn't have to work in the morning. Good. What about Maria's boyfriend?
Sería igual. María's boyfriend doesn't have to pick her up in the afternoon.
Doesn't have to pick. Have to pick her up in the afternoon. Excellent. Do you understand the negative? To express obligation. We say, I don't have to. I don't have to go. I don't have to study. I don't have to work. I don't have to play. Right. This is a negative sentence. Now, look at this. To express a question, to say a question using have to, we use this structure. The auxiliary do or does goes to the beginning. This is the simple present tense. do and does changes the position, and in this place at the beginning. Then we use the personal pronoun, the expression have to, and then the verb. And I say, do you have to go now? Do you have to go now? This is a yes, no question. Hey, do you have to study now? What about you? Do you have to study? ¿Tienen que estudiar ustedes, chicos? ¿Qué me dicen?
Yes.
Yes, I do. Yes, we do. Yes, they do. Yes, he does. Yes, she does. Does your mother have to cook tonight? Does your mother have to cook tonight? Yes, she does. For the negative, we say, no, I don't. No, you don't. No, we don't. No, they don't. Or no, he doesn't. No, she doesn't. So this is a question. Here we have some examples. Now, change this into a sentence. Change this sentence into a question. What could be the question? The first one. My sister doesn't have to study for the test tomorrow. Change into a question. This is the structure.
Repeat again. Are you?
No estamos utilizando el verbo to be. Estamos utilizando el verbo do y does. Por tanto, no va el verbo to be.
Does.
Yeah. Hey, pay attention to this. The auxiliary do or does, it comes to the beginning. We place at the beginning of the sentence. And I say, does my sister, have to study for the test? Does my sister have to study for the test tomorrow? And this is the question. Does my sister have to study for the test tomorrow? What is the answer? ¿Cuál sería la respuesta?
Yes, I...
No, porque estoy diciendo my sister. Does my sister... Si en la pregunta tienes do or does, en la respuesta va do y does. Como esta es una yes, no question, tienes que decir yes or no.
She does.
Pero yes or no.
Yes. Yes, she does.
Yes. Yes, she does. Very good. Yes, she does. In negative?
No.
No, she?
She don't.
Doesn't. No, doesn't. No, she doesn't. Yep. Repeat, doesn't.
Doesn't.
Very good. Yeah, what about the next? This. You don't have to speak English in class. What is the question?
Do you have?
Mm-hmm. Do?
To speak English in class.
Do you have to speak English in class? And the answer?
Yes.
Yes?
You do?
You do?
Uh-uh. If the question is for you, you say, hey, do you have to speak English in class?
I do.
You say, yes, I do. ¿Tienes tú que hablar inglés en clase? Sí, yo tengo. ¿En negative?
No. No.
I don't.
¿I qué?
I don't.
Don't.
No, I don't. No, I don't. Good. What about the next? He doesn't have to swim. In the pool. What?
Does he have?
Mm-hmm. Does, the auxiliary goes to the beginning. Does he have to?
Do a swim in the pool now.
Swim in the pool. Swim in the pool. El now mejor no le pongamos. Yeah. Does he have to swim in the pool? Right. Good. And the answer?
Yes, he does.
Yes, he does. In negative?
No, he doesn't.
Doesn't. Excellent. And the next. My dad doesn't have to work in the morning. What is the question?
No.
Repeat, everybody. Das.
Das.
Das. Repeat. Das.
Das. He died. No.
Das.
Das.
My dad.
My dad.
Mm-hmm.
Have to go in the morning.
Does my dad have to work in the morning? Yep. Remember, have to, it is used to express obligation. I have to speak in English. I have to work. I have to study because it is an obligation. Do you have to study? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Right? Do you understand? No questions? About have to for an obligation?
Teacher.
Okay. Yeah.
Does he have to write a funny note?
Uh-huh. Does he have to write a note in Spanish? Right, good. Now, obligations. What do you have to do after class? My example, hey, what do you have to do after class? After this class, what do you have to do? For me, it is an obligation. I have to get some groceries before I go home. So I have to go to the supermarket. And what about you? What do you have to do after class? Do you have an obligation after class?
Have to.
I have to.
I have to.
Mm-hmm. have two after class. What do you have to do after class? After English class, what do you have to do? Carmita. What do you have to do after English class? No? Carmen, Maribel, Silvana. I
do.
¿Dónde está el do?
English class.
I have to do homework. Like this?
Yes.
After class, I have to do homework. Okay. What do you have to do after English class? Oh, I have to do homework. Yeah, good. And Edward, what do you have to do after English class?
I have to sleep.
I have to sleep, yes, because you are very tired, so you have to sleep. Excellent. And Silvana, after class, what do you have to do?
I have to the work in the hotel.
Mira lo que estás diciendo. I have to the work.
Work.
At the hotel. ¿Está correcto, chicos, esto? Dice clarito la regla que necesito have to y el verbo solito, el verbo work. Este de está de más. I have to the work, no. I have to work at the hotel, yes. After English class, I have to work at the hotel. Yeah, very good. And Carolina, what do you have to do after English class?
I have to go in the house.
Mira lo que dices. In the house significa en la casa, dentro de la casa. ¿Está bien decir yo tengo que ir en la casa?
The house.
I have to go home. Cuando quiero decir tengo que ir a casa, utilizamos go home. I have to go home. Yo voy a casa. Tengo que ir a casa. I have to go home. Good. Excellent. Remember, I don't have to study. I don't have to sleep. It means no obligation. I don't have to be there until 7, for example. Right? Questions about have to and has to express obligation? No? I think it was clear. Okay, now let's remember the present continuous and the simple present tense. You remember the present continuous. What is the present continuous? Here I have an example in the present continuous. I am taking driving lessons. I am playing the guitar. We are going home after class. Here we have present continuous, sentences in present continuous. When do we use the present progressive or present continuous? To express temporary situations, to express actions which are happening in this moment. ¿Qué estamos haciendo en este momento? What are we doing in this moment? We are studying English. We are studying English. It also is used for future arrangements. Hey, look at this. Expressions used in the present continuous are the following. Now, right now, at the moment, today, these days, this week, this year, tonight. If you see these expressions, we are in the present continuous. Now, what is the difference between the simple present tense and the present continuous? Simple present tense is used to express habits, customs, routines, usual activities. For example, David writes every day. Every day, it means that the action is a habit. Es un hábito, una costumbre, una rutina, presente simple. Give me some examples of habits. For example, I get up at 6 a.m. Para mí es un hábito levantarme a las 6. Es una costumbre levantarme a las 6. Simple present. I get up at 6 a.m. Habit, customs, routines. But the present progressive or the present continuous, it is used to express that an action is happening in this moment. For example, David is taking lessons on Monday. It means that the person is, in this moment, this person is taking lesson. Is taking lessons on, we can say, on Saturday. I am taking lessons on Saturday. Actions which are happening now or extended present. It means in the future. Present, in the future, yeah? So, look at this. The simple present tense, in affirmative sentences, we add the letters S or ES to the verb. Write, writes. ¿Se acuerda que para el presente simple aumentamos la S o las letras ES al verbo principal? Solo con he, con she y con it, aumentamos S al verbo o ES. Para indicar que estamos en simple present. But the present progressive, it has the auxiliary of the verb be, is, am or are, and the principal verb plus the ending ing. Para indicar que la acción está pasando en este momento, digo, David is taking lesson. In this moment, okay? Now, what about the negative sentences? In the simple present, we use the auxiliary do or does as an auxiliary and say, she doesn't exercise every day. She doesn't exercise every day. Present, simple present. That means habit, custom, routines. But the present progressive or present continuous, this is used to express that the action is happening in this moment. And I say, she isn't exercising right now. The auxiliary of the present progressive is the verb be, am, is, are. And also the negative form, isn't, aren't. Exercising, the principal verb plus ing. I am studying English right now. Because the action is happening in this moment. What about questions? A, questions in the simple present, they have the auxiliaries do or does. At the beginning, does David write every day? In the present progressive, the question is, with the auxiliary of the verb be at the beginning, is David writing right now? Okay, so here we have the difference between two kinds of presents, simple present and present progressive. Simple present actions that are habits, customs, routines. Present progressive, actions that are happening in this moment. Right? For example, here I have the verb call. According to the picture, we say she, her grandmother every week. Every week. Right now, she, her. So, where is the simple present and where is the present progressive? Acuérdense, el presente simple es un hábito, costumbre o rutina que se representa con una expresión de tiempo que puede ser cada día, cada semana. Yo me levanto cada día a las 6. Yo me levanto todos los días a las 6. El present progressive, it is used to express that an action is happening in this moment. So, what do you think? Simple present or present progressive? Vamos. She. She calls her grandmother every week. This is the simple present tense. Hey, ¿se acuerdan que al presente simple le aumentamos una letra S al verbo cuando estemos con he, she, and it? Porque este es un hábito, una costumbre, una rutina. Si yo digo cada semana, rutina. She calls her grandmother every week. But now, right now. La expresión de tiempo, right now, que significa en este momento, ¿qué está haciendo ella en este momento? Present continuous.
She is talking, calling her.
Now she's calling her. You see? Simple present, habit, custom, routine, every. Right now, action that is happening in this moment, it is the verb be and the principal verb plus the ending ing. Okay, very good. Now, pay attention to this. There are, in this case, she's calling her. This is the present continuous. Remember, the present continuous or the present progressive needs the principal verb and the ending ing, que significa ando, endo. Dice, David está riding, montando su bicicleta right now. Riding in this moment. Now, there are some verbs which don't admit the ending ing. For example, the verb want. The verb want, it doesn't express movement, it doesn't express action. Hay algunos verbos que no expresan acción. For example, the verb play. When you say play, I play, there is movement, movement, there is an action, play. But the verb want, where is the movement? What is the action? Yo quiero. No hay acción en el verbo. The verbs that don't have action, they are called non-action verbs. And non-action verbs, they don't admit the ending ing. Even we have the expression right now, aunque tenga la expresión right now that the action is happening in this moment. So we use the simple present tense. I want some water. No, we don't say, I am wanting. El verbo want no admite ing. Non-action verbs, they are not used in the present progressive. They don't admit the ending ing. Want means physical or emotional need, and we don't use ing with this verb. The same happened with the verb smell. When I say smell, what is the smell? Smell means oler. ¿Dónde está la acción del verbo? There is no action. So this is a non-action verb. And non-action verbs are not used in present continuous. We cannot say, are you smelling? We say, do you smell it too? In the simple present tense. This verb express sensory experience. So, these kind of verbs are non-action verbs and they don't admit ing. Okay? They are not used in the present progressive. Here we have some other examples of non-action verbs. First, that express senses, emotions, perception, and opinion. With all these verbs, we cannot use ing. Hating, liking, disliking, wanting, needing, preferring, minding, no. No non-action verbs, okay? Now, let's have a review about the past tense of the verb be. Right. Let's see. In present, when we have the verb be, this is the verb be, I am. I am in class today. This is in present. I am in class today. In the past, I was in class yesterday. Time expression is very important. Yesterday means that the action happened in the past. In present, I say, Jane is here today. I say, Carolina is in class today. Silvana is in class today. But in the past, I say, Carolina was in class yesterday. Maribel was in class yesterday. We are happy. We were happy yesterday. So, in present, the verb be has three forms. Am, is, are. But in the past, to express the past, we have only two forms. Two forms. Was and were. Was is used with I, he, she, and it. And I say, I was in class yesterday. He was in class yesterday. My mother was at home yesterday. My cat was in the park yesterday. And for the plural, we, you, and they, not only the plural because this is singular too, we say we were, you were, they were. If the verb be in present means ser o estar, yo soy, yo estoy, ella está, in the past tense it means yo fui, yo estuve, ella estuvo, ella estaba, ellos estuvieron, right? So, the verb be has two forms, was and were. Yeah, let's see. An example. I was on vacation last week. Time expression is very important. I was on vacation last week. The weather was nice. My hotel was comfortable. The restaurants were very expensive. So here we have the verb was and were to express past. Do you remember when were you on vacation? When were you on vacation? Do you remember your vacation? Your vacation? No? Okay, anyway. So, give me some examples using the simple past. The past time was. Yeah, give me some examples. Where were you yesterday? For example, ayer, ¿dónde estaban ustedes?
I was in the work.
I was at work.
I
was at work yesterday. Excellent. I was at work yesterday. What about your sister? What about your sister?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Edward.
I was in the park.
Yesterday. La expresión de tiempo es importante. I was in the park yesterday. Okay. Carmita, where were you yesterday, Carmita? Carmita. No, Carmita is not in Ibarra. Carmita. Oh, she's gone. Come on, give me more examples. Using was or where. Where were you last week? And last week? I was in Ibarra last week. I was in Quito last week. Okay. Now, to say in negative, we say, I was not. I was not in class yesterday. In conjunction, we say, I wasn't. The conjunction of was and not, it is wasn't. We say, I wasn't, she wasn't, he wasn't, it wasn't. So what about you? Give me an example using I wasn't. Hello?
I was. No?
I wasn't, okay?
Not in the university yesterday.
I was not at the university yesterday. Okay, good. I wasn't at the university yesterday. Right. For you, we and they, we say, were not. In negative, in contraction, we say, weren't. We weren't. We weren't in class yesterday. My parents weren't in Quito yesterday. You weren't in the disco yesterday. Okay, negative form. Okay, let's complete these sentences. I say, I wasn't on vacation last week. What about you? Give me another example. I wasn't on vacation last week. You? You? What? You weren't, okay. Yeah, complete. You. You weren't. Sorry, I can't listen. Silvana, Mary. You weren't happy yesterday. At the party, you weren't happy yesterday. You weren't happy yesterday at the party. Yeah. What about my brother? Tell me an example using my brother.
My brother wasn't in the same class as Peter last year.
Excellent. My brother wasn't in the same class as Peter. Wasn't in the same class as Peter last week. Okay, very good. What about Maria? Maria? Maria wasn't
hungry after workout.
Yeah. Maria wasn't hungry after
workout.
Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. After workout. The hotel. The hotel wasn't comfortable last month. Yeah. We
weren't busy yesterday.
Busy? We weren't busy yesterday. Yeah, we weren't busy yesterday. And finally, they
weren't here yesterday.
They weren't here yesterday. Excellent. They weren't here yesterday. Okay. They weren't here yesterday. And this is a negative sentence. Good. Now to form a question. In the question, remember was and where they are placed at the beginning. Before the subject. Say, hey, were you in class yesterday? Maria, were you in class yesterday? Say, yes, I were. Yeah, I'm sorry, yes, I was. In singular. In plural, I say, hey, were you in class yesterday? And you can say, yes, we were. We were in class yesterday. For negative, were you, all of you, in class yesterday? No, we weren't. We weren't in class yesterday. Okay? These are yes, no questions. With the third person, was Jean at the library last week? Yes, she was. Long answer, she was at the library last week. Negative, was Jean at the library last week? No, she wasn't. She wasn't at the library last week. Right? Now, hey, look at this. This is an information question because before was or where, we have a question word. In this case, when. When was your flight? ¿Cuándo fue tu vuelo? When was your flight? And you can say, yesterday. My flight was yesterday. When was your class? Maribel, when was your class? Say, last week. My class was last week. Okay? When was your birthday? When was your birthday? Hello? I can say my birthday was in October. My birthday was in September. My birthday was in January. All right? This is a yes, no question. And this is a question with who. When we are asking for the subject of a question, we say who. Who was at the party? And always we use was. Who was at the party? Mary was. Mary was at the party. Now, let's practice the use of the past tense of the verb be. Number one, please, when were you at the beach? This is an information question. When were you at the beach? Silvana, Maribel. Hello. What could be the answer? When were you at the beach?
Last weekend
I was at the beach. Were you on vacation last week? This is a yes, no question. Carmen, were you on vacation last week? Carmen? No. She left. Maribel?
In the Quito City.
Yeah. Were you on vacation this week?
Okay.
Sorry, repeat again.
Quito City.
This is a yes, no question. So, the answer could be yes or no. ¿Estabas de vacaciones la semana pasada?
Yes.
Yes, ¿qué? Yes.
Where?
No puedo decir I wear porque con I no funciona wear.
Yes,
con I funciona was. Yes, I was. ¿Se acuerdan lo que les enseñé acá arriba? Con I, he, she, and it, we use was. Where is used with we, you, and they. So you say, I was. Were you on vacation last week? Yes, I was on vacation last week. Oh, no, I wasn't on vacation last week. How was the service at the restaurant? If you were on vacation, maybe you went to a restaurant. How was the service at the restaurant? Hmm? Do you understand the question?
Excellent.
Excellent. Yes, that's a good question. You can say it was excellent. It was excellent. It was terrible. It was awful. How long were the Wilsons in Europe? How long? It is an expression used to express time. How long? For a week, for a year, for 2 weeks? For 15 days? The Wilsons were in Europe for 3 days, for example, for 5 days, etc. Okay. All right, we have time. Yeah, we have 15 minutes to express the simple past. ¿Se acuerdan que teníamos el simple present con el present continuous? Son dos clases de presente. Simple present, present continuous. Ahora tenemos el simple past, but in this case we are talking about simple past using all verbs, the whole group of verbs. Example, watch, answer, speak, write, go, the whole list of verbs, except the verb be. So, to form the past tense, we add the ending ed to the principal verb. Ed to the principal verb. But in English, we have two kinds of verbs, regular verbs and irregular verbs. You say, they watched a movie last night. Alexandra answered the question yesterday. So we add ed to the verb, to the principal verb. And this is in the past. The sentence is in the past. Now, the ending ed, estas dos letritas que añadimos al verbo para formar el pasado, it has three different pronunciations. We don't say cleaneth. In the past, we don't say cleaneth, loveth, studied, no. We say like a letter D, in this case, cleaned. Suavito, cleaned, loved, studied. Sometimes we pronounce with a letter T, a clear T. We say brushed. No digo brushed, ni toqued, ni watched. Digo con una letra T. Esta ED, it is pronounced with a letter T. Brushed, talked, watched. Watch, después de watch, la letra T, watched. Pero tengo que sonarla. Watched, talked, brushed. And when the verb ends in the letters D or T, like in this case, need, invite, to pronounce the extra syllable ED, and we pronounce the ED with an extra syllable, and we say needed. Aquí sí digo needed. Invited, invited, needed, with an extra syllable. This is about the pronunciation of the ending ED to form the past of regular verbs. But we have irregular verbs. For example, this. Sleep in present. The past tense of sleep, it is slept. The past tense of understand, understood. The past of eat, it is ate. So some verbs, they have their own forms. Say, we slept in intensive camp last summer. I understood most of the directions yesterday. Time expression, it is very important. And this is an affirmative sentence. Yeah. Here I have a sentence. I bought new shoes yesterday. I bought new shoes yesterday, but I didn't like them. Negative. The first sentence is affirmative, and the second, a negative. My friends came to my party, and we played some games together. We have two sentences in the past, okay? Now, what happened here? What happened to them? These verbs are in present. What are the past tense of the verbs? The verb fall down in present. In the past, we say fell, fell down. In present, we say break. What about the past? What is the past? Do you know what is the past tense of break? Huh? No? The past tense is broke. In present, we say cut. In the past, we say cut. The same. In present, we say hurt. In the past, we say hurt. The same. Burn, this is regular. In the past, we say burned. Burned. So, what happened to them? Number one, picture number one. What can you say? He? He? Carmita, Carmen, Maribel, Silvana, Mary, Edward, Carolina. What happened to them? Number one.
He fall down.
In present, fall. In the past, fail. Say, he fell down on the stairs. Yeah, he fell down on the stairs. What about picture number two? This picture. He. He, using one of these verbs, no, no idea. Carmita, Maribel, Carolina. What happened to him?
Break.
In the past?
Broke.
Broke. He broke what? I'm sorry, repeat again. Could you repeat again? No, unfortunately, I can't hear. So, picture number two, we can say he broke his arm. And number three, what about number three? He? Huh? In the past, he hurt, yes, this one. He hurt his back. This is the back. He hurt his back. And this? What about this? He or she? Burned. E-D. His finger. And what about this? She. In the past, what happened to them? She? Cut his hand, her hand. He cut her hand. More examples. I say in present buy, in the past bought. Repeat everybody, bought. Oh. See, saw. Drink, drank. In present, read. The pronunciation in the past, it is read. Ride, rode, shot, shot, teach, taught, think, thought. Now, give me examples. My example. I bought new shoes yesterday. I bought new shoes yesterday. Now, give me another example using one of these verbs in present, in past. One of these verbs in past. Hello?
I saw.
I saw a cat. Yeah, we can say I saw my friend. I saw the doctor. I saw a cat. I saw through the window, etc. I read a novel yesterday. I rode in the park last week. I shut the door. I taught English last month. I thought it was a good idea. For example, now we have some minutes. For the negative sentences, do you remember for negative sentences, we need an auxiliary. The auxiliary for the past, it is did. I did not. And the base form of the verb. In present, affirmative sentence, we use drive, in the past, drove. But in the negative sentence, as we are using the auxiliary, the verb comes to the base form. I did not drive, they did not drive. So, with a personal pronoun, you use did and not. In contractions, didn't. I didn't watch a movie last night. And I didn't play soccer yesterday. So give me examples you didn't do in the past. Didn't. Give me more examples. For example, I didn't go home last... I didn't go to my parents' home last week. Yeah. I didn't watch a movie. I didn't play soccer last month. I didn't play what? Oh, yeah. Okay, my dear students, unfortunately, we don't have more time. Thank you very much. This was a very short video about the simple past. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you.